800-675-5091. You're watching Weekend Now. Stay tuned for your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
And welcome back to Weekend Now, and it's a beautiful day to hit the beach in much of the South. Let's take you traveling across the country as we check our travel tips out for you. One thing is, you're looking good at the airport. These hubs, Atlanta, Miami, Seattle, and Denver, weather not providing much of an impact, and that's good news to report, just some showers in Seattle today. As we check on the interstates, not bad up and down the East Coast, I-95 South Florida, maybe a storm later. I-25 Pueblo to Cheyenne, maybe a thunder sprinkle. I-5, that looks like the worst one here on this chart. From Portland to Seattle, showers today. And of course, if you're crossing the Cascades, snow levels down to 3,000 feet or lower, so yes, you'll have to contend with snow. I-80 traveling through Iowa, you'll be getting wet. I-35 country just off to the east, seeing some showers and light thunder showers. Here you can see I-5 northwest, it's a wet ride. Also Highway 101, once you get up to Eureka and Crescent City, Northern California. I-90 near Spokane, a soaking rain coming in. So high terrain snows, maybe a little slushy on some of those passes above 3,000 feet. Thunder sprinkles, gusty winds, beware of that as you cross over the summits on I-70 and I-80 and I-40 today. And as we check on the fog, not a major concern. Winds, though, revving up from the southeast in the plains today. So on those east-west highways, you could feel that crosswind. How about the boat and beach report? Well, if you're headed off to the beaches in the northeast today, some pretty brisk winds, and it's a chilly wind at that. Those waters icy cold, only in the 40s. Only the brave go in the water here at this time of year. Here you can see an easterly flow in Florida. Maybe a little rough on those east coast beaches. West coast, though, looks wonderful. A great day at Sanibel to head out and pick up those seashells. And as we check on the west coast, onshore flow, and of course, water is cool here most of the year. Now let's check in with Melissa.
And we're airing a new feature on Weekend Now with the help of the Weather Channel Latin America, our sister network. We'll bring you a series of reports on the weather in South America. This time, we'll focus on the Caribbean islands. Here's Katrina Voss with your World Weather Watch.
Well, let's take a look at what's been going on across the Caribbean. This same cold front that moved through southeastern United States brought colder weather to places like Georgia and northern Florida. This is sitting right now right in the Straits of Florida, and it's been causing some rain here in La Habana. Now, for the rest of the islands, over towards Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic, things are starting to dry out. In the next couple of days, we should still see a few showers, some occasional showers, but nothing like what we've been seeing lately. And I should mention that we could have some rough seas, so keep your eye out for maybe some small craft advisories. Here's your forecast. The temperatures are going to continue to be pretty high, around 30 degrees Celsius. That's about 90 almost in terms of Fahrenheit. And as you can see down towards Caracas, we could even see a shower. Now that's pretty unusual, but we're starting to see this moisture from the Amazon just come right on up in towards Colombia and Venezuela. Back to you.
Thanks a lot, Katrina.
And of course, stick around next on Weekend Now. With spring rains on the way, how can you keep rain off your roof? Danny Lipridge shows us how.
And here's our weekend weather question of the day. What is a cap or lid? The answer coming up later on Weekend Now.
Are about to witness an amazing demonstration of the most revolutionary lawnmower blade ever invented. It's the new patented Safety Cut Blade, the safest, most effective lawnmower blade you've ever seen. Watch Safety Cut Blade attack this obstacle course. Rocks, wood, metal tools, even a rake. Nothing jammed, nothing got damaged. The secret is Safety Cut's flexible cutting wands. Engineered to safely deflect off objects, they bend around anything solid in their path. The only thing they cut is grass. Metal blades are dangerous, but Safety Cut Blade deflects off every solid object, even feet. It's simply amazing.
Each year, thousands are brought into emergency rooms all over the United States with serious lawnmower injuries. My own son nearly lost his leg from a lawnmower blade. I strongly recommend using the Safety Cut Blade.
Best of all, Safety Cut Blade eliminates dangerous ricochets from flying objects so you can safely mow your lawn without fear for your family or your property. Watch. We placed a glass pane in the path of the Safety Cut Blade and mowed over golf balls, rocks, and debris. The glass is unbroken. Then, we switched to an ordinary metal blade and mowed over the same area. The glass shattered from the shrapnel. The ricochet is as dangerous as a bullet from a .357 Magnum.
My son always got out of mowing the lawn because I was afraid he'd hurt himself. But with Safety Cut Blades, there's no more excuses.
Universal Safety Cut Blades adjust to any size lawnmower, and they only take minutes to attach. They work with every brand of lawnmower, any make, any model, from self-propelled to riding mowers. Made of a specially formulated plastic, they never need sharpening. Now order the Universal Safety Cut Blade System for $29.95. We'll include a second set of blades as a free gift. You get it all for $29.95. For safety's sake, call now.
To order your Safety Cut Blade, have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-351-7300 or send check or money order for $29.95 plus $6.95 shipping to the address on your screen. Call now 1-800-351-7300.
Meet Springsteen Night at 8 on Atmospheres. See how the weather makes a big difference when the Blue Angels fly. Plus, Caribbean windsurfing. Can meteorologist Mitch Michaels handle the elements? Don't miss Atmospheres Wednesday nights at 8 on the Weather Channel. Real people, real weather.
Information, call us 1-800-203-3100 or order online at drtrimmers.com.
It's the best investment I have ever made.
You're watching Weekend Now. Stay tuned for your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
for our weekend wow and a rare video of a funnel cloud. Last Sunday, a tornado dropped from the clouds in Nebraska. One man was injured. A photographer from an Omaha television station captured these pictures. The twister only stayed on the ground for a few seconds as the storm spun across the plains in about 60 miles per hour. Now, many of you have heard of this encryption from a U.S. Postal Office in New York. Neither snow nor rain nor heat nor gloom of night stays these couriers from the swift completion of their appointed rounds. This week on Atmospheres, see how postal workers who must deliver the mail around the Grand Canyon stick to the credo. Check it out tonight at 8 and 11 Eastern Time right here on the Weather Channel. Mark?
Well, a soft rain falling on the roof can be a nice sign of spring. But when a heavy rain pounds on the roof, it's a different story. In this Lifestyles report, Danny Lipford shows us how to install a rain diverter on your roof.
Now, you may live in a part of the country where it rains a lot. And if so, you've probably considered installing gutters on your home. But you may have held off on that because you dread the idea of having to clean those gutters. But without some way of controlling the water that runs off of your roof at your entryways, it's a real mess when you try to come and go from your house. Solution might be a simple rain diverter. This type of metal is readily available at home centers, very easy to install. And what it does is it redirects the rain from one side of the entryway to the other, whichever side's more desirable. Now, as I said, it's very easy to install and a lot easier to maintain than gutters. Once you've chosen the location for the diverter, move up the roof edge about 2 to 3 feet and carefully pry up the bottom edge of the shingles. Slide the long edge of the metal under those shingles. Situate the diverter so that one edge is slightly lower than the other. This will ensure that the water runs off in that direction instead of backing up under the shingles. Usually, a 1-inch drop for a 6-foot diverter is sufficient. Nail the upper edge of the diverter down using 1 5/8 roofing tacks, but be careful not to break the shingles while you're bending them back. Finish up by applying a little roof cement to the top of each nail. Now, even though you don't have to scoop this out like you would a gutter, it's still a good idea to take a broom and sweep the debris out occasionally. Well, you're ready for the rain, and the only thing you have to dread about falling leaves is having to rake the yard.
For weather information, visit weather.com. And for more home improvement tips, todayshomeowner.com.
And stay with us. There's much more to come on Weekend Now, including an in-depth look at today's weather maker.
This program was sponsored by the Delta Faucet Company. Delta, the faucet. Check out the latest pull-out spray from Delta. With a radical design, combining beauty, practicality, and just a touch of attitude. Delta, the faucet.
Lobster Fest at Red Lobster is almost over. Time to go overboard with all the sweet, succulent, mouth-watering lobster you can sink your seafood-loving teeth into. So come in for Lobster Fest and go overboard.
You love seafood, we love seafood. Let's meet at Red Lobster tonight and go overboard.
Oh, a new patient. How you doing?
I get a lot of new patients with fleas or ticks.
Poor baby.
Even though their owners thought they protected them. Because only one product protects cats and dogs against fleas and ticks. New Frontline Plus. It's the best. Now it provides complete flea protection. And it's the only one that also kills ticks, including the ones that carry Lyme disease.
That's cute.
New Frontline Plus. For fleas and ticks, Frontline is the veterinarian's number one choice.
Oh, hello.
Right now at LensCrafters, you can find prescription sunglasses for only $99. All our sunglasses filter out the sun's harsh glare to help you see your best. There's nothing wrong with looking your best, too. Hurry, event ends soon.
If only your house could talk, what would it say?
A little house like me deserves a beautiful garden.
Even if you've never planted a seed before, come to Lowe's. Because we have certified nursery specialists who will help you choose the perfect plant. And every plant we sell is guaranteed to last.
Just look at this garden. It's like I have a whole other room in the house.
Lowe's, improving home improvement.
Spend $299 on your Lowe's card and get 6 months. No payments, no finance charges.
You're watching Weekend Now. Stay tuned for your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Coming up next on Weekend Now, call it parade-perfect weather for your outdoor plans in Texas and across the South. We'll show you why.
Will the picture-perfect weather in New York and the Northeast stick with you this weekend? We'll check it out in our weekly planner.
And here's our weekend weather snapshot. Warm in the Southeast, cool in the Northeast, and damp in the West. We put it all together along with your local forecast and travel weather just ahead.
Good morning and welcome to Weekend Now, the show that helps you plan your weekend activities around the weather. I'm Melissa Barrington.
And I'm Mark Mancuso. Thanks for joining us. And for most of you, it will be a great weekend for outdoor activities. Let's take a look at that big picture for you. Most, if not all of us, enjoying just perfect weather, picture postcard weather, chamber commerce weather across the South. Can't describe it any other way. But look what's happening here in Canada. Cold air is dumping down across the Great Lakes into the Northeast. Very large but chilly high pressure coming into the Northeast today. So if you are headed outdoors today, running some errands, make sure you put on a jacket and a sweatshirt. It's a frisky breeze that's coming right down through the Mid-Atlantic region. Leading edge of that cool air now, passing the border of Virginia and North Carolina. Behind the front, temperatures start to reverse in direction, dropping 5 to 10 degrees from yesterday at this time, all the way from Columbus on over to Concord in New Hampshire. So here's the cooling trend, 70 in Charlotte, 61 in D.C., 55 New York City, and only in the 40s in Boston. Air, though, pretty dry as the front comes down the East Coast. Notice the dew points in the 30s and 40s, so the front comes through quietly, just a few clouds and sprinkles, while farther to the west in the plains, some showers and some thunderstorms rolling down the Mississippi Valley, where there is a little bit more in the way of low-level moisture. Now let's check on the weather story, and here's Bill Keneally with more.
And Mark, thank you very much. What's making weather today? Well, today's weather maker dealing with that jet stream and the jet stream up to its dastardly deed again. Namely, we have a big ridge in the heartland. So what does that mean? It is getting warm. Somebody paying the price, though, namely farther upstream, and that would be with that trough over the western states, as we have a decent amount of rain on tap for today in the Washington, Seattle area, and also heading down towards Portland. Now, beneath that ridge of high pressure, what's happening? This air is being forced up and over the top of this big dome of high pressure. A better vantage point would be that three-dimensional look. And again, literally, that air is lifting as it is rising. It is cooling and condensing, and presto, you have a showery day in Seattle and Portland. Meanwhile, you get over the apex of that very top of that ridge, you start to sink that air. And as you sink that air, you compress the air, you bring those molecules together, and you start to heat that air up. And that is indeed what is happening. Not necessarily bad news either. As you know, this flood-ravaged area along the Red River to the north and also in the upper Mississippi could really use some dry weather. We're getting that so you can get out there and do what you have to do. In addition, the bulk of the catch basins are relatively dry today. Then you throw in the added element of a downsloping wind. Remember now, there's a low to your north and there's also a high to your south. And either way, you get that clockwise flow around it, and that's downsloping off of the high peaks in the Rockies. And you're looking at readings upwards of 25 degrees above normal, and that plays out with highs, we think today, in the middle 80s out there in Bismarck. And if you're feeling kind of slighted in the northeast, hanging there, that big ridge is headed your way by about midweek. Now for more on that chilly northeast, here's Melissa.
Well, folks in the Northeast are going to be looking forward to that warm-up that Bill was talking about. But in the meantime, today, right now, compared to 24 hours ago, for many of you, it's actually where it was yesterday exactly, or it's actually colder. 8 degrees colder, for example, in Albany, and 13 degrees colder in Cleveland. As we look at the actual temperatures, it's chilly. 44 in Buffalo and Albany, but warmer in New York at 55 and 61 for you in Washington, D.C. Even have some wind chills, especially across parts of upstate New York and northern Maine. It feels like it's only 13 in Caribou, so still some chilly air here. And look at the winds. Check it out. Right now, winds are gusting to 28 miles an hour in the Boston area. And you saw the flags flying earlier this morning. There it is. For those of you walking along the shoreline, need a jacket and also, of course, not shorts, but at least long pants because of the coolness and also because of the wind. Temperatures today expected only to be in the middle 50s in the Boston area. But at least there is some good news there. You are seeing plenty of sunshine, 56 for your afternoon high, 64 in Philadelphia and 65 in Pittsburgh. Now come tonight, it's really going to cool off quickly. You're going to need a jacket or sweater if you have evening plans, especially if your kids are going off to prom, because overnight lows will be dropping into the 20s. For your plants, though, frost and freeze warnings are in effect across parts of the Northeast, and it's all due to cool front that slid its way across the Northeast yesterday. High pressure building in with hardly a cloud in the sky. Your forecast here across the Northeast for today, do expect to see high pressure continuing through the midday hours. And by later on this evening, our area of high pressure very slowly tries to work its way eastward through tomorrow morning. Could be a little bit crisp as you go outside to grab your early morning paper. Let's take a look at your forecast here in the Philadelphia area. Grab those shades as you go out and about later on today. Plenty of sunshine. Highs for today near 65 degrees. Winds will be on the breezy side near 20 miles an hour. Now with a check on the south, here's Mark.
And if you like warm weather, the south is the place to be. Case in point, Tampa, Florida started the morning with temperatures around 60 with light winds. The jacket felt good as your weekend plans lifted off. Won't need it later today, though, that's for sure, as it'll be sunny, warm, and dry. And as Melissa said, get out the shades and also get out the sunscreen. Won't take long to get a burn today in the southeastern United States. Yesterday, what a gorgeous day it was. Look at these temperatures, 70s and 80s across the board. We'll see more of the same today. Fantastic weather from Dallas to Atlanta to Tampa. There is a front dropping down through North Carolina this morning. Clouds, maybe a sprinkle near it. We'll have to watch out, though, in the mountains of North Georgia, Western North Carolina. A little bit of an instability here. So if you are planning a trip up to the mountains today, do a little bike riding, maybe up around Cades Cove. There is the chance for an isolated thundershower this afternoon. Temperatures look great in the south. Air is still pretty dry here. Not a lot of moisture to work with that front. And the wind's mostly light, but a pretty good breeze cutting across South Florida. There is an area of disturbed weather in the Gulf of Mexico. That'll move east. Chances for rain go up in Florida next week, so hang in there. As we check your forecast out, the front comes down through the southern Appalachians today. Again, be wary of an isolated storm in the mountains of North Georgia this afternoon. Aside from that, mostly dry weather in the south. Eventually, we'll get some wet weather into South Florida. As we check on our weather for Miami for today and for tonight, we are calling for warm and breezy with a chance for an isolated shower storm this afternoon. Melissa?
Light rain fell early over parts of the flood-stricken Midwest. Fortunately, you didn't see very much. That's good news for those of you who are still sandbagging. The St. Croix River has climbed to a 36-year high, flooding some homes in Minnesota and Wisconsin. This is the second round of flooding rains for the region, thanks to the recent rains. And you can see here in the Midwest, we're dealing with gusty winds, warm temperatures, and also some light showers that are occurring right now right along the Mississippi River. Fortunately, though, it's not very heavy. For those of you across the Great Lakes region, high pressure in control. It looks like a beautiful day in Cleveland and also around Columbus, Ohio. But the winds are gusty in the nation's midsection and they'll continue to strengthen later on today. Right now around Minneapolis, gusting to 24 miles an hour. And especially from western Minnesota, western Iowa, right along the border here is where we're going to deal with windy travel later on this afternoon. Some light showers here across eastern Iowa and also across western Illinois. Waterloo, you saw some light rain, didn't last very long. Still some light rain reported right now in Cedar Rapids and also some light showers here along the Mississippi River. St. Louis, most of the rain is generally to the east, but you still may see a shower or storm later on today. 57 in Indianapolis, 54 in Chicago, and 68 already in Kansas City. Beautiful day in Kansas City with a high of 81. Just a few showers possible generally around St. Louis on northward. Let's check out your forecast here for later on this afternoon. Our warm front doesn't move very much come the midday hours, and by later on this evening, still basically in the same place. Strong southerly winds. We do have a few wind advisories in effect here across the central plains. And by tomorrow morning, mainly dry across the Midwest, but those winds will be howling from Iowa northward through Minnesota and also across Wisconsin. Speaking of Minnesota, here's Minneapolis, your forecast for today. It's going to be really gusty here with the winds blowing out of the southeast at 20 miles an hour with higher wind gusts, but temperatures will be comfortable, 76 degrees. Now with a check on what's going on out west, here's Mark.
And you'll find it a damp day in the northwest and in the Rockies, but in California, the weekend got off to a majestic start yesterday. More than 400 sailboats headed to sea from Newport Beach in a race to Ensenada, Mexico. Just a few clouds dotting the sky, temperatures in the 60s. What a gorgeous sight that is. As we take you to the west, well, yesterday the heat was on in Phoenix again, second day in a row of 99, just tickling 100 degrees here. Glasgow, Montana, a record high of 87. Spokane hit 77 yesterday, not so today. Morning rain, cooler air coming in from the Pacific. The Northwest looking cool and unsettled today. That means showers mixed in with sun breaks around Seattle and Portland. Waking up to a mild 62 in Salt Lake City, Phoenix 73, Denver looking good with a 55. Here's the front moving through the northwest. Rain along the front, changing to showers behind it. Snow levels dropping down to 3,000 feet. So if you're traveling through the Cascade Passes, you could have some problems. As we check that forecast out, just a little bit of moisture sneaking up through the Rockies. So again, like yesterday, some thunder sprinkles, maybe a few thunder showers in the higher terrain. Watch out for that if you're camping or hiking. Southwest, dry and mild. Let's show you LA. Forecast looking good here. Los Angeles, morning low clouds give way to afternoon sunshine. Forecast high in the low 70s. So if you're planning on doing some sightseeing in Los Angeles today, look for a hazy sunshine in the afternoon hours.
Still ahead on Weekend Now, what does the week ahead hold for your weather? We'll help you plan it coming up.
And we have a question of our day for you, and that is, what is a cap or lid? And here's the answer. It's a layer of relatively warm air that inhibits the development of thunderstorms. When that cap's broken, though, explosive thunderstorms can result. Stay with us.
Use an ordinary pain rub on your arthritis, and everyone knows it. Use odor-free Asper Cream instead and get clinically proven fast-acting pain relief nobody knows about but you. Aspirin-free Asper Cream. Fast relief no one knows about but you.
I'm a Gold Bond guy. Ordinary body powders don't work for me, but Gold Bond body powder is medicated to work as hard as I do. Gold Bond powder keeps me cool, dry, and itch-free.
Gold Bond body powder. Medicated to work as hard as you do.
Empire will adapt and continue to thrive. Our software has helped more companies evolve their infrastructure than anyone else on Earth. Hello, tomorrow. We are Computer Associates, the software that manages e-business.
To demonstrate how quickly new Capstar kills fleas, we gave Lucille a Capstar tablet 30 minutes ago. Observe. The fastest relief with no pesticide residue.
It's amazing.
It's Capstar. To demonstrate how quickly new Capstar kills fleas, we gave Herman a Capstar tablet 30 minutes ago. Observe. The fastest relief with no pesticide residue. It's Capstar.
You're watching Weekend Now. Stay tuned for your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
We'll be right back.
No other television network on the planet has more meteorologists than we do. The Weather Channel is like a walking, talking set of weather encyclopedias, and we'd like to share our knowledge with you. So we've created a new feature designed for you to take advantage of our expertise. It's called eWeather. You email us, and we'll answer your questions about weather or the Weather Channel on the air. And our first question comes from viewer Cindy Johnson. She asks us, what's a jet stream? Where is it, and how does it influence weather? Well, Cindy, a jet stream is a river of relatively strong winds, and there can be different jet streams at various levels in the atmosphere. The Weather Channel's jet stream map usually shows the polar jet stream, which is a current of strong winds within the general west-to-east flow, several miles above the Earth's middle latitudes. The polar jet stream can be flat or can have big dips and bulges, and it can also split into branches. Now, the polar jet stream is caused by the horizontal temperature variations, and that's why it's typically most pronounced above strong fronts. Consequently, the polar jet stream migrates north in summer and south in wintertime. And this jet stream frequently defines the storm track as it helps to steer and energize the highs and lows you see on the Weather Channel's maps. The most active weather is often found just ahead of big dips called troughs. And if you have an eWeather question, email us at weekendnow@talktoweather.com. And we may just answer it on the air. Right, Melissa?
That's right, Dan. The big question is, after showing you all the jet streams, will it have an effect on your weekly plans? Let's check it out as we take a look at your weekly planner. And we start with Sunday, the second half of the weekend. And notice here it's going to continue to stay dry across the northeast, much of the southeast. That's some great news for those of you with outdoor plans. But some scattered showers in the Pacific Northwest and also some mountain snows here for you. As we take a look at your temperatures for Sunday, definitely shorts weather, especially across the central plains. Highs will be in the 80s. And across the northeast, 40s and 50s. But notice that as we look ahead into Monday, we'll actually start to see some warmer air push its way into the northeast here for you. And the cool spot will actually be in the Pacific Northwest with temperatures only in the 50s and 40s. As we look ahead to your Monday weather, we're going to be seeing some scattered showers across parts of the upper Midwest. And into Tuesday, we'll see the rain continuing to spread across the northern half of the country. And moving on into the middle of the week. Notice here a lot of wet weather, especially across parts of the nation's midsection, with some scattered showers and storms. To recap, we're going to be dealing with some scattered showers and storms in the nation's midsection on Sunday, and get ready for a warm-up across the northeast. And Florida, you'll be seeing a chance of some much-needed rain. Mark?
Okay, a lot of people happy about that in Florida. Still to come on Weekend Now, air ducts can help heat and cool your home, but not if they leak. Just ahead, our home expert shows us how to fix the problem.
I don't even know why I bother. Do you want to go home? You don't pay attention to what I say. You're not even listening now, are you? No, what are you doing? No, no ducks! Bad dog! No! Mother of pearl!
People do some strange things to cars. That's why there's Carfax. We'll give you the real history of any used car, and that could save you thousands. Go to Carfax.com or ask your dealer for a Carfax report. Don't buy a used car without Carfax.
I'm going to see about a credit card.
Rejected?
You have no future!
But I just got a great job!
Run, little man! Run!
What kind of bank is this?
Take that! Honey, I already got us a Capital One card.
Million people have chosen Capital One to help build their financial future. So you don't have to put up with the same old banks. Check your mailbox or log on to CapitalOne.com today for some of the best rates in the nation on products like CDs, money market accounts, and platinum cards.
Next applicant!
Capital One.
What's in your wallet?
Next Wednesday night at 8 on Atmospheres, see how the weather makes a big difference when the Blue Angels fly. Plus, Caribbean windsurfing. Can meteorologist Mish Michaels handle the elements? Don't miss Atmospheres Wednesday nights at 8 on the Weather Channel. Real people, real weather.
Can your radio do this? Only one radio can give you stereo sound this big, yet is small enough to fit almost anywhere. The extraordinary Wave Radio from Bose. Press the remote control and hear big, rich sound that fills the room. Sound so rich, popular science called it a sonic marvel. You hear music the way it was meant to be heard. Clear, full, incredibly lifelike. You've got to hear the Wave Radio to believe it. And now you can, satisfaction guaranteed. Call toll-free to hear it in your home. Ask about our popular interest-free payment plan. Experience big stereo sound from a radio. Call today.
With our 12-month payment plan, the Wave Radio CD is just $41.58 a month.
You're watching Weekend Now. Stay tuned for your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Dogs deliver cool and warm air to your home, but if they leak, you can have a problem. Home expert Danny Lifford tells us how to fix them.
Now, when it's really cold weather outside, one of the most valuable commodities in your home is the heat that's produced by your furnace. Why waste it? A yearly inspection of your ductwork will allow you to find any leaks, just like we found right here. All of the torn tape that we have around this supply line is allowing that heat to rush right out, not benefiting us downstairs. Now, the solution here is very easy. Take any type of brush to clean off any of the dust that may be on the outside of the ductwork. Then you can find an aluminum foil tape, just like we have here with a peel-off back. Just tear off sections of it. It's real easy to use, very inexpensive. And you just apply it right over any of the areas that you may have found. Use plenty of it. Just push it in place, and that'll seal off any of the areas. Now, some of the other areas you may want to be checking on include where your smaller supply lines tie into the trunk lines. These are areas that can come loose, that can be knocked loose. You need to check those very carefully. Also, where your supply line ties in to your vent going into the individual rooms is also an area that can come loose, again, causing you some problems. Now, if you'll take care of these few little maintenance items on your ductwork, you can benefit from all of the heat that your furnace produces instead of just some of it.
For weather information, visit weather.com. And for more home improvement tips, todayshomeowner.com.
And if you have a great picture of stormy weather, we'd love to see it. And you can enter it in the photo contest we're holding in connection with Storm Week here on the Weather Channel. Send your entry to weather.com/stormweek. Deadline is May 9th. Winners will be chosen in four categories and announced during Storm Week, and that's June 4th through June 7th.
And in case you have a question that you would like to email us, be sure to send it to weekendnow@talk2.weather.com.
Thanks for joining us. Have a great weekend.
This program was sponsored by Certainty Building Products. For durability and ease of use, it's quality made certain, satisfaction guaranteed.
This is our dream house.
Some dream.
Come back down this way.
Took him 2 years to choose the building materials.
It's like a canary, isn't it?
He's obsessed.
I'm thorough. I have this whole card catalog system. Did an interview process on the crew.
I just need some information.
So we're thinking about going turn of the century in here. That sound good? I like to know what's under the carpet. You know, what's over my head. I chose Certainty. I really trust their products.
It's exactly what the builder said 2 years ago.
Are you going to put this up now? Can I help? JJ?
Do your lines and wrinkles make you look years older? Are you really happy with the face looking back at you in the mirror?
I wasn't, and that's why I created Firmalift. I'm Lee Valentine, and now you can enjoy my age-erasing miracle that lifts years from your eyes and face, giving you back the tight, toned, youthful-looking complexion you thought was lost forever.
It's amazing. Fine lines and wrinkles around the eyes reduce dramatically. Just look. Age lines between the nose and mouth have all but disappeared. Your entire face, tight, toned, lifted, and looking up to 10 years younger. International beauty consultant Lee Valentine developed Firmalift's revolutionary formula with the breakthrough ingredient Elastazone, which is clinically proven to reduce the appearance of your lines and wrinkles in just days.
Within the first 3 days, I noticed a softening of the wrinkles. It's different than any other product I've ever used.
I noticed the lines here had decreased. My skin felt fuller. The little crow's feet had gone away. I couldn't believe it.
Why spend thousands on cosmetic surgery or creams and cosmetics that don't make you look younger? Now you don't have to. Firmalift, the revolutionary age-erasing miracle, can be yours for just $39.99. But wait, call in the next 17 minutes and we'll also send you a second bottle of Firmalift absolutely free. Normally $80, they're both yours for only $39.99. But only as part of this limited introductory offer.
Firmalift is not available in any store, and it comes with my personal guarantee.
We're so sure you'll look up to 10 years younger in just weeks. Firmalift comes with an exclusive 60-day bottom-of-the-jar guarantee, so there's absolutely no risk. Call and receive your own free Firmalift now.
Call now to receive Firmalift, the age-erasing miracle, for only $39.99. Plus, call in the next 17 minutes and receive a second Firmalift absolutely free as part of this exclusive TV offer. Firmalift also comes with a 60-day bottom-of-the-jar guarantee. If you're not looking years younger, return even the empty bottles for a full refund. Call for your own Firmalift now.
Watch Storm Week, four nights of the most intense weather you'll ever experience on the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is brought to you by this cable or satellite provider. You can also get reliable forecasts from the Weather Channel through this radio station.
Watching Weekend Now. Stay tuned for your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
stiff breeze is blowing in Beantown today. It's mostly sunny but cool with winds gusting to 25 miles per hour. What can you expect across the rest of the Northeast? We have the answer coming up next.
And it's a perfect day for a balloon race in Tampa. You're enjoying generally partly cloudy skies, and your temperature should top out in the low 80s, and your forecast for the rest of the South is straight ahead. And here's a quick look at the rest of the country. You'll have showers yet again today in Seattle and Portland. Warm temperatures in the Southwest, hot and dry in the upper Midwest. And Weather Center is up next.
Hello and welcome to this edition of Weather Center. I'm Kelly Cass. Thanks for joining us.
And I'm Bill Keneally. Kelly, cool, dry air streaming in from Canada, coming right down the pike. In this case, the New York State Thruway with eyes on the Big Apple.
That's right. But don't you worry. Things will be warming up as we head to the next several days.
That's right. Hang in there. It's going to take a little doing, but again, chilly for a couple of days. And by the way, frost advisories, frost warnings up there. We'll talk about that in detail momentarily. We do have some upside.